Welcome to Caramba, proof that you don't need $1 million to cruise the oceans comfortably and see all they have to offer. We are a family of four who've been doing exactly that for a number of years, and Caramba has provided a safe and enjoyable platform from which to visit some truly extraordinary places. We've owned Caramba for over 20 years and completed an extensive refit in 2014. We had no intention of ever selling Caramba, so no expense was spared and no system overlooked. However, our plans have changed, and that means a unique opportunity for someone else to continue to enjoy all the oceans have to offer from the decks of a truly remarkable blue water vessel. The following video will provide a brief overview as well as details of some of her key systems. Thank you and enjoy. Caramba is not a production boat filled with veneers and thin cabinetry. Solid teak, plantation grown in Costa Rica, graces her warm and inviting cabin. 13 solid bronze port lights as well as 3 large hatches provide ample ventilation and light. Her well-equipped galley has provided many wonderful meals over the years for not only our growing family, but for all of the friends we have met along the way. A quarter berth with its own door, hanging locker and table, and cabinet provides a snug berth under passage, or just a nice place to get away and play some Legos. A light and spacious salon with a pull-out berth to starboard and a drop-leaf solid teak table is a wonderful space to enjoy the company of friends you meet along the way. Ample storage is provided both above and below the settees with multiple access points. Moving forward, we see both the head and V-berth that we will detail later in the video. Thanks so much for watching. Hello and welcome. This is a short video explaining some of the key elements of the galley aboard Caramba. Starting here on the right, we have our integrated fridge and freezer. This is the holding plate system from Technotic's Cool Blue. We opted for one of their larger holding plates and have been quite happy with the system. It not only has the Danfoss compressor, but a separate receiver dryer and evaporator unit, so it's really quite robust and efficient. We also re-insulated the entire icebox a few years back, just to make sure everything is as efficient as possible. So that's that. Moving up a bit, we see our upgraded stereo that we installed just a few months ago. We like it because it has a nice Bluetooth range that enables us to control music selection and volume from our phones and tablets. It also has a powered USB port right here that helps us charge an iPad that we have up here in the galley, and we use that as one of our navigation stations, as well as to scroll photos, read recipes, and things like that. Next, we have our Dickinson Mediterranean 3-burner stove. It has a nice large burner back here that is really useful in helping get a pressure cooker up to pressure quickly. The oven portion also produces a nice even heat and is surprisingly large. We actually cooked the Thanksgiving turkey for the Anchorage this year, and it came out really, really nice. So naturally, it also has a locking gimbal down here, so you can unlock it when you're on passage, and then you can lock it again when you're at anchor, and it stays nice and solid there for you. Also, naturally, a propane sniffer, alarm, and shutoff right here. Sniffer's back there by the stove, and then that's the stove. Real happy with that system. Next, we have our Seagull 4 water filter system. It's a very thorough filter that always ensures our water tastes great and is really nice to have as a last line of defense in our drinking water system. And of course, nice deep double stainless steel sinks. And I'm going to pull this out here. Nice pull-out faucet here with a spray unit. Just recently upgraded and installed, so that's working really well for us. And then the saltwater tap that we have over there to the left. That is installed about a little less than 2 years ago, and it's powered by let me get under here and show you the whale gusher foot pump. naturally goes through its own dedicated through hole, sea strainer, and then on to the saltwater tap. And it really saves on the freshwater, which is really nice. And then speaking of freshwater, we have our double freshwater pumps here. That is, we have the Spectra Cape Horn Extreme water maker. And one of the nice features about that water maker is that it does have the double pumps. That ensures not only redundancy, but also dramatically increases the flow. So you get quite a bit more flow for a product, and you also get much higher water quality, which is really nice. And then we also have the gauge and water pressure gauge here, and then the water flow meter here, and then down below the sink again, I don't know if you can get this, but we have the test to tank switch there, as well as that's where our test tubing comes out as well. We like to have that all focused in the galley just for ease of use. So it keeps it all in one spot, keeps all the water there, and works very, very well for us. And then finally, in our galley, we like to have a lot of light and storage. We have a nice, deep storage space here with a shelf. And then back here, we have also a cubby back here that goes pretty deep. We have Alpenglow LED lights, three separate lights in the galley area. They toggle to red for night vision. And then we have our white LED light bar, which helps us see what we're cooking. So that's Caramba's galley. Thanks for watching. Hello and welcome. This is a short video highlighting some of the key features of the head aboard Caramba. So starting with the interior overall, the shower surround was refinished a few years ago using all grip in all areas except the sump. There we use gel coat as it's better suited to the continued wet environment. And this is the gel coat factory, or not the gel coat, the all grip factory non-skid. Works really well, it's held up very well. Onto the head itself, we have a Raritan PH2 manual head with a full-size bowl. When living aboard, really felt it was nice that we have a full-size bowl. Felt that was important, and the reliability of the manual Raritan PH2 is very well known. In fact, legendary, I would say. So, and that's definitely been the case for us. You'll notice the small elevated platform the bowl sits on. That's not only for comfort, but it also helps ensure the system remains as high above the waterline as possible on all points of heel. That's a key safety feature that we further enhanced with the high anti-siphon loop here that we've installed. And we have a new anti-siphon valve in there. As a matter of course, we replace all our anti-siphon valves on a very regular basis. That one was just a couple of months ago. So that's a new anti-siphon valve in there. We opted to keep the plumbing overall as simple as possible while ensuring, obviously, reliability, because you don't want anything to go wrong in the head, and adherence with local regulations, or likely regulations. So everything from the head goes directly into a holding tank. There's no Y valve to leak or clog or to lock or anything like that. You just goes right in the holding tank, and from there you can either pump it overboard or you can have it sucked out through a pump out facility by simply adjusting a heavy duty bronze Grocco three-way valve that's located down there, which is a lot more robust than any of the three-way valves you would find on the head diversion systems. So that's a more robust solution there, and it enables you to adhere with local regulations and everything. So the head discharge pump we selected was called the Dometic T-Series pump, and we searched long and hard for the most reliable pump we could find, and that won hands down. We obviously do have a full spare pump, as well as the duckbill valves available as well, but we haven't had any reason to use it. It's been a very reliable pump for us. You'll also notice this hose in here. This is throughout the head system. This is this $12 a foot non-permeable hose. It's extremely slick on the inside and non-permeable on the outside. So it's perfect head hose, really the best you can find. What else? So we also have a shower system in here that you can hook up to the faucet. That's why we have the automatic and manual bilge pump here that goes to the sump. It sucks it out of the sump, up through here into the sink, and it's a pretty slick system. We also have a cockpit shower that's really nice that we installed as well if you wanted to use that. A couple of other points in this area. So the boat, the entire boat has been rewired. Not only was all the wiring inspected for continuity and any corrosion issues, but we also wanted to extend the capacity of the system. So what we have here is we have a fused switch panel here with excess capacity, and we also have a fused non-switch panel under the cabinet here that has excess capacity as well. So if you wanted to add any fans or lights or any other accessories, you could very easily do that and very correctly do that. We also have the tank monitoring system here as well. This you might be familiar with. It's the tank tender system. It is pneumatic, so it works on air pressure alone, so that's very reliable. We monitor two water tanks and our holding tank with that. It has a spare capacity for any other tank you'd want. You could use a diesel tank, but we have gauges on both our diesel tanks as well. So, you know, it's just spare capacity in case it's needed. We also have our favorite Alpenglow LED lights here. This one in particular, these are like all the others, white or red. But this one at the factory is sealed, waterproof, because there could be additional condensation issues in the head. So that's a sealed waterproof light there. We also have quite a bit of storage in here. You can see all the lotions and potions here on the shelf there, a large shelf. Then down here we have what are called, snap-tainers. And they come out here and they're individual containers. They snap up and they store real nicely. Definitely watertight for condensation and things like that. We also have those in the V-berth. We have quite a bit of storage back here and two big lockers that go all the way down there. One we use for clothes hamper, one we use for other medical supplies, and that works out well too. So that wraps up our head tour. Thanks for watching.
This video highlights the V-berth on Caramba. The bed has a very comfortable custom-made spring mattress with pillow top that has been protected by a custom-made waterproof mattress pad cover. Custom templates are available to make a new mattress pad cover and sheets, if so desired. The mattress folds midline to allow access to the forward water tank that has a clearly visible C-built inspection port. In addition, there are lockers on each side aft of the water tank for good under-bed storage. Additional storage is available midline under the bed with access open to the aft. There are three Caframo Scirocco fans located in this berth that add additional air circulation to the large hatch above. There are also two articulating brass Alpenglow LED lights with dimmers. Finally, the forward end of the V-berth is the anchor locker, and that will be presented elsewhere.
Hi, this is a quick video on Caramba's engine and engine compartment. What we have here is a Beta Marine, 50 horsepower, professionally installed new in 2014, including all engine, electrical, and plumbing. It has the full-size oil sump for better lubrication on all points of heel, as well as an extended oil change interval. You'll also notice here the Balmar AT series alternator. That's the advanced technology series alternator. Much more reliable and a better power output curve when things get hot, as alternators do. A definite upgrade from the standard Balmar alternators, as well as anything that comes with the Beta Marine engines. A couple other quick things on the engine. We've got the raw water impeller speed seal here for quick impeller changes if you need them. Really easy to change the impeller on this thing. Then you also have the oil filter there, easy access. You also have in the very back here an oil pump that goes directly down to the sump. Really makes oil changes very easy. You just took a hose there and put a jug there or in the front. Really easy to change the oil and get a complete oil change there. In addition, we have the what the Brits call the calorifier, which is fittings that go to the water heater to heat your water. We also can heat the water on AC power when at the dock, but this is for when you run the engine, obviously. We have a very robust and heavy-duty muffler back there. A definite upgrade from what you'll see on some boats have those Vetus mufflers. This is a very heavy-duty muffler that we have back there. In addition, we have, speaking of heavy duty, you can't see it really that well here, but we have the starter. We've enlarged the starter post, and we run double-aught wiring to the starter. No voltage drop there, and we have a Group 27 battery for starters that we have installed in the cabinet back there. So let's start with fuel system, talk about that real quick. So we go from a lower tank, we pump up to a day tank that's located up here. We first pump through a fuel water separator here for the initial fuel filtering, and then we have an optional fuel polishing system. The pump is there, and then we have a Raycor 500 FG series turbine water fuel separator back there. You can turn that off and on as you want to. It doesn't have to always run, but it's nice to be able to polish the fuel. Then from the fuel tank, the day tank, which as you'll know is located above the engine, which is a benefit, you will then go through an apparatus here, which is a Filter Boss priming pump, which is useful when you're doing filter changes, as well as a redundancy for in case you have any fuel pump issues. So that's the fuel priming pump there. You then go into another Raycor here, which has shutoffs there and there, so you can isolate it for fuel change or filter changes. And then it goes down to the filter on the engine. So that's your fuel system. Power is transferred from the engine to the max blade or the max prop 3 blade feathering prop via a BorgWarner Velvet Drive transmission, which is rated for something like 450 horsepower, so definitely plenty of oomph there. You go through a flexible coupling down to a Aquamet 22 prop shaft, which is really good prop shaft material. We had that put on when we did the refit as well, to a PYI dripless shaft seal, through a cuprous oxide stern tube, and then onto the max prop. So that's the propulsion system. Couple other real quick things here in the bilge area. We obviously have bilge pumps. There's your manual bilge pump, a whale gusher pump in the cockpit, and then we have a diaphragm bilge pump here, which is really good for the deep bilges that the Cabo Ricos have. We have that hooked up to a sensor that you can easily get to there for a bilge pump counter and alarm system that we have. And then we have a crash pump. The hose for the crash pump is there. It's a 2-inch reinforced hose going to a dedicated through hole well above the water line and run by a Rule 4000 centrifugal pump, which is tied directly to the battery. Then the last thing I think we have here, we have a blower system for ventilation. It goes out its own ventilation port. And then obviously we have the bronze raw water strainer for the raw water pump and the water strainer for the saltwater tap at the galley. And I think that's about it for the engine compartment on Caramba. Thanks for watching.